All right, welcome back. So let's take the top part of this vision class so that we can take our conditions later. So from this, you can calculate your surface charge density or your electric field intensity based on the data. You also remember to describe electric potential. Involving two charges. The one that I described earlier, only one charge, only one distance. So in this one, we have two charges located at Q1, Q2, and they are separated by distance RA initially. Then one of the charges is moved to a new location. Let's say Q1 is moved. Q1 is moved. You see that in the problem at home. They move one of the charges to a new position. So in that case, the new distance between them will now be initial distance is RA, new distance between them. So Q1 is moved to this place, Q1. So new distance becomes RB. So they're asking to find the electric potential between the 2 points charge. So in that case, my V is simply KQ bracket 1 over RA minus 1 over RB. Now, how do I know the Q to use? It is a Q that is not moved that you are going to use in this case. So I am assuming that Q1 is not moved. So what I am going to use is going to be Q2. Because Q2 is not moved. It's Q1 that is moved to a new location. So that's the formula for your electric potential V. Now, in most cases, this area comes with calculating the work done. So, what is the work done in moving the charge to a new location? So, the work done in moving the charge to a new location is simply, as usual, work done to QV. So, the Q I'm going to use here is the Q that was moved to a new location. So in that case, Q1. What's my V? The V obtained from this expression. So again, I work done. So you must remember that. Another aspect of your electrostatics that we discussed, vectors. When there are specific problems on Coulomb's law or electric field intensity and you want to deal with your vectors, Coulomb's law. In unit vector notation. Now, recall that F equals to K, Q1, Q2 over R squared. Square root of ry squared plus ry squared, the SRT squared, the YRT squared. So we'll consider questions later, and I think we also describe these with questions while in class. So just know the formula, understand how to apply it, then you are good with column store in vector formula. Another guy that is a vector in your topic is electric intensity. So you now have to define E in vector form. Electric field intensity in unit vector form. So you are looking for E in vector form. Recall that E equals to K cube over R squared. Similarly, vector E becomes K cube over mag R squared dot vector R. So 1, 2, 1, 2. Other things remain the same. R12 is empty like version under a force. So that's vector problems. So calculations can come in different forms. Given three charges on a straight line, three charges at the points at the vertices of a triangle, you can give them four charges at the corners of a rectangle or a square. Just get a good diagram, they understand the basics, then apply your formula which you want, the answer should come out. Then, okay, to also remind you of what we call equipotential surface. Potential surface. Remember, we describe it. Any surface where we have equal potential is an equipotential surface. This potential is the same throughout or constant. So, what are the features of equipotential surface? V equals to constant or the same. Now, since V is constant, we expect E to be zero because normally E is V or delta V over R. So since V is constant, E is zero. Since V is constant again, or E is zero, we expect to work to be zero. These are the features of an equipotential surface. Can be your MCQ. Then we also describe the applications. Don't forget the whole essence of electrostatics is production of charges, manipulation of charges, application of charges. So, what are the areas where electrostatics can be applied? So, electrostatics can be applied in lightning conductors. So, there are some tall buildings that have lightning conductors on the roof. The conductors are there to accumulate the charges in the atmosphere and pass them to the earth without causing problems to the buildings. If those charges accumulate and there's explosion, they can strike that building and can collapse. So we manufacture lightning conductors to attach them to the top of tall buildings, they pass through the whole building to the earth to safely accumulate the charges and transfer them to the earth so that there will not be a sudden explosion. The action of a car or automobile plug is also electrostatics. So the spark plug, once you strike it, it can ignite a mixture of fuel and air, and that leads to burning, and from there the engine can run. So all these are aspects where electrostatics can be applied. Coronal discharge is also another aspect of electrostatics, not coronavirus, we call it coronal discharge. When we are able to keep charges, use them at the later point, we call it coronal discharge. It's another aspect of electrostatics. Action of the television tube can also involve the basic knowledge of electrostatics. So these are areas that where electrostatics can be applied. So I think I've revised the basic concept of electrostatics. Let me see if we can solve one or two problems. Consider the rest. during our interactive session at night. One or two problems. So we have 2 point charges. So we have K, T1, Q2 over R squared. Nothing mentioned about the charges. Then remove your Q. So in that case, F equals to K over R squared. The problem is between F and R alone. So in that case, F R squared equals to K, F1 squared, F1R1 squared equals to F2R2 squared. So, looking for F2 in terms of F1, by what factor does the resulting force between them change? So F2 over F1, that's what we can do, equals, that's going to be R1 squared over R2 squared. So F2 over F1 becomes R1, initial distance is 8 squared. R2, final distance is 4 squared. So in that case, F2 by F1 becomes 2 squared. So F2 by F1 becomes 4. So in that case, F2 is simply 4F1. So by what factor will the resulting neutral force change? From here, the force we increase since I have perhaps F1, we increase by a factor of 4. So we are going to discuss further calculations at night. We stop here for today. See you next time.
Then pick your spot.